This young man, 21-year-old Stephen Cousins from England. Stephen Cousins, a stylish young skater. He is appearing in his second Olympic Games. He finished 12th in Albertville 2 years ago, and a good friend of yours.
And no, he has no relation to Robin Cousins, the 1980 Olympic gold medalist. Triple axel, double toe! I have never seen him land that in front of people. He's got to be excited. Last jump element, a double axel. He was one of the few skaters that didn't mind the pros coming back. He said, give me an opportunity, I'll compete with anybody. What a great job by Stephen Cousins.
Christy Yamaguchi, the gold medalist from 1992, kind of liked that. Great Britain is rated first. Brian Boitano is in second place, and Victor Petrenko is third.
So how did a hotshot like Steve Cousins catch up with Steve Disson?
I think I did my first show for Steve maybe about 10, 11 years ago when it was still called Star Skates. And then basically from then on in was doing shows with him ever since, maybe one a year, two a year. So it's basically developed from there.
What's your role here, Steve?
I'm the artistic director and choreographer of the show. I mean, the process starts usually in around April when we find out what shows we're doing and what artists that will be in each show. And so it's my job to put together all the numbers for the show and assign music for all the skaters, and then also choreograph when it gets time to do it. The gymnastics is separate. They have their own choreographer here. However, it's for me to put together timings of the opening, where it's gymnasts or skaters or gymnasts and skaters together. And then coordinate the running order and make sure that it works for both sides. Skating time, it's usually around about 45 minutes per hour.
At some point, you got to cut out some of these acts to get to that 45 minutes.
Yep.
The actual show that we'll see tonight runs longer.
Yep.
Is that your call?
No, actually, it's TV's call. But it is run by myself and by Steve as well.
Competed 3 Winter Olympics, 9 World Championships, 9 European Championships.
Yep.
First Briton to land a triple axel in competition at Lillehammer.
Yep.
Was there a highlight moment or two in Steve?
Yeah, that landing the first triple axel. It created history, but it also, it was at the Olympic Games, so it was kind of a good time to do it.
We've always told him that's all you need is a triple axel. Look at the tightness of rotation, great prep. Carries a speed across the ice, nicely landed 1 foot into an easy double toe.
Amazing, bud.
Wow. Once again, it is straight, perfectly positioned in the air, good air position, nice and tight rotation, and all you have to do is tap for that double toe.
Doug Lee, his coach. Nicely done.
It changed the way I competed. Because if you didn't have a triple axel at that time, you weren't considered a contender. So it changed everything where, you know, you go from being someone that's kind of just an also-ran to, okay, you know, got a chance at medals and stuff like that. So I think that would be the biggest highlight. Winning the first national championships, being the youngest one to do it, that was another highlight. But I mean, everything I did was, even if it was bad, it was also a highlight. And it was a it was a great career. I had a great time.
So give me your best Steve Disses throw.
Wow. There's so many. I'm trying to think of one that's not going to get me fired.
I'll cover it.
All right. I mean, well, if you ask anyone, it's reminders. Like, he'll remind you that he's reminded you five times before on a reminder that happened yesterday. So you'll have five emails reminding you on the email that he sent to you, but it was only like yesterday that he sent it. And he always starts it with thanks again. So any time I'm having a conversation with Steve, I'll make sure that I say thanks again. He's one of the, you know, all joking aside, he's the one person that, you know, will put himself on the line and really does protect and take care of his athletes. And everyone respects that. And everyone's very grateful for it. So it's, you know, long may it continue.